got these.
Future day.
I'm done.
They're done.
I'm canceled. I've been fired. I've been laid off. Look, Future Jay right here.
That's funny.
He looks better than me, smarter than me, reads better than me, smells better than me. I'm done. Knows more about reptiles too, I'm sure.
We're gonna bring it in and show you.
Oh man, we're in trouble, guys. I'm gonna have to find another job. You got any ideas what I should do for a living?
This is Dark, and then this is Gomer. We've had all of them. We have had all of them for.
Jumps out. Here, you go ahead and feed him down. Get him settled down.
There we go.
Just give it to him over the tank.
To the water, though.
Seriously. You guys forget how to eat. Whoa! I got you. We got him. He's okay.
Oh, man. So good.
Okay, now the question is, are you ready to feed him out of your mouth now?
There we go.
Trust me, tapping him on his nose will not hurt him in any way.
Okay, so I am the one that trains them. So these guys, I work with them constantly, and when I feed them, I'll give them pieces of chicken so they get riled up, and because they're just excited to eat. But then I also will take the chicken away because these tongs will help train them, and that they know when they get tapped on the nose that they're kind of overdoing it. They're just getting really excited. Whoa! Where did you come from? I like to tap them on the nose to sort of let them know.
I'm not gonna trust you. That's the only gator that's bit me, and it's bit me twice.
That's the girl. The girl's cranky.
She's a cranky girl. She likes chewing on my arm.
But usually in those moments, it's us trying to do something or work with them in a different way that we're trying to learn them. And you know, sometimes when you work with animals, that's what happens. You get bit, you get moved around, but we do it to make sure that they can have an environment and make sure that they are trusted. But we gotta work with them. It's part of the job.
Now, I'm gonna clarify another thing. Alligators are not pets. These are for educational purposes.
Not pets.
I don't even think they're great pets if you live in Florida. At the end of the day, they're very dangerous. They're capable of eating kids. You can ask Disney about that, unfortunately. It's happened multiple times at Disney World.
We're gonna try to get a snapping turtle. It's pretty hard for these guys.
There you go.
He's got,
we got a snapping turtle down there kind of thinking, hey, what about me, man?
So sometimes when I'm feeding them, I'll just put a piece of chicken in. And then once they fall on the ground, then the snapping turtles will get them. I don't know if you guys can see this guy. They kind of make the water a little murky, but... Nice job, dude. Oh, sorry, not you. Good job.
Seem excessively on show off mode tonight. They seem to like the crash.
Sure. Okay, now they're all full, ready to go. Alright. Come here, dudes. Come here. Hi. 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 I like to think that they like me, but they just really love my tongs. But it is what it is. So see how he kind of like knows me in that way? I mean, yeah, these guys are so smart. That was my fault, I'm sorry.
So that's Darth Gator. He was named on Facebook about, I don't know, 8 years ago. And so we didn't create that name. It was created by lots of people. It was actually the number one that kept coming up. And Disney called us up and said, wow, you've got more followers than we do. No, I'm kidding. But Darth is really cool. He's actually my favorite. They didn't hear that.
No, Darth knows.
They only got vibrations. Darth!
They all say.
Typically, when they're calm and there's not a lot going on, I can call Darth and he'll come over. Gomer's the middle one right here.
Yeah, right here.
That's Gomer, that's Kyle.
And they look like the same size, but Darth, he carries all of his weight in his tail and his belly. So afterwards, because we feed him so heavy, they're going to go probably up here in the next like hour or something. Look at his chunky belly. It is like me and my dad put together.
Oh, man, that's huge.
Yeah, I put myself in there.
Come on, come on, come on, come on. Show these people what you're made of.
Now, okay, but you guys see them, they're like, I'm not sure.
She's like, I want to jump.
Yeah, they're like,
but I really want Dart to jump. Come on, Dart.
Their stomachs are full. Oh,
yeah.
Bobby over here is like,
come on.
Excuse me?
Yeah, we have to be here. We'll be here right before the party's over.
Yeah.
He dances like me. Come on, Dart. Yeah, man, you're just so gentle. You are like crazy. You haven't even finished your food. Come on. Come on, Dart. Come on. Come on.
Yeah, Bummer's got four pieces of chicken in his mouth. They have intense FOMO, where they're like, I gotta get that piece. I gotta get that piece. That piece is mine. And you're like, didn't swallow. What are you doing?
He's got it. Okay, so what's next, Juliet?
All right, next we have Saving Wildlife. We have a presentation right over here.
So, how many have seen a YouTube video or Instagram video or something with a baby snake? I see a whole bunch of hands. These are actually reticulated python eggs. And so they start out smaller than this, and they actually keep growing. Now here's the unique part. You see this egg right here? You can see the baby right there. So what happens is, see it moving around there? So there's actually a baby right there. See, I can make it drop and I can make it move. The baby actually starts out at the very top of the egg. A lot of times people think the day the egg is laid, that baby just happened, right? But actually what happens is the female breeds, and then she decides the date that, man, it's a good thing people don't do this. So they decide later, it could be 2 months later, they decide to fertilize the egg. After the egg gets fertilized is actually the time when they shell them. And when they put the shell on the top of them, so there's an egg inside, and it's a follicle. And then as soon as it actually gets fertilized, they put this shell over it, and we call that ovulation, but really she already had the egg. So that is when they shell them. When they shell them, they actually go in the shed about 15 to 20 days later. Then they shed, and then 30 days later, they actually lay the egg. Now, it depends if the female sits on the hot end or the middle, on what temperature that is, how many days she decides to lay those eggs. But roughly, after she lays those eggs, it takes between 76 and 86 days to hatch. We really never know when they're gonna hatch. We call this a window. And when a snake gets older, you can totally see the baby right there. It looks like it's to be an albino, but it's a good possibility that what I'm looking at is a yolk right there, because it's still got another month to go. But what we got here is a bunch of baby snakes. Now these baby snakes right here are coming out of these eggs. So you can see there's a whole bunch of grumpy ones. So what's gonna happen is when I put my hand over here, I'm gonna get bit. But the good news is I'm gonna have Jalen put his hand there so he gets bit.
Let me get bit.
See, they don't like him. They'll bite me. So anyway, ow, that one actually bit me hard. I get bit by 20 footers and it bothers me less than putting my hand in front of a baby one and getting bit. Now the reason why it's gonna bite, you can see it actually broke the skin. I'm not gonna die, it's not venomous.
Paul's over here. Venomous. Oh, Paul's over here.
Now, Paul got one that's really upset, so it wrapped him up. So this is a normal reticulated python. In the wild, they're very aggressive. They're very smart. They're I think, the smartest python there is. I haven't really owned cobras. Cobras are supposed to be really intelligent. They'll just go back and forth until they find a weak spot in the cage and literally try to exit through that weak spot. Retics, for instance, if I'm pulling a clutch of eggs, most people don't know, when they're striking, I'm usually baiting them for the strike a little bit in the respects of, I want to know where the strike's going to come. So I purposely give them a target so that I know I can talk and I'm not going to get bit in the face. Because if they just stand there with a blank stare, I don't know what they're on. And so I don't really want to get hit in the face because I'm misjudging where they're at. So just like swinging it right here. So they can't, so in the wild, I guarantee you in real life, it's going to always strike in my eyes. Because guess what's attached to your eyes? You are. And if they take the eyes out, they got you, right? How many people seen the Kung Fu videos when the bad guy throws the dust in the eyes and it looks like it's all over, but the good guy wins anyway? Well, that's not real, because you can't see anything. Good luck. And so snakes, particularly the pythons, go after the eyes. Of course, that's how they grab their rodents. They almost always catch them in the face because they're getting their where they're breathing, they wrap around, they constrict, they're literally constrictor. The funny part is every snake is really a constrictor if it's not venomous. So when I'm pulling a clutch of eggs, I purposely will allow the snake to find my hand as a target and make it a little bit more accessible than my face, because I really don't want to get bit in the face. And I really want to be able to do my video, and the snake is gonna want to protect the baby. The snake is gonna be scared because these baby snakes, at the end of the day, everything wants to eat them. That's why they have, a snake can lay 400 eggs in its lifetime. But if you stop and think about it, how many of those could possibly be surviving if they're a threatened species? Now, because we're in captivity, guess what happens? They get used to being held. They realize they're not getting eaten. Before you know it, they can be nice. It's just like people, when you're around somebody that you find out isn't as a nice person, you don't have to protect yourself. You can just be yourself and enjoy life. Well, it's the same way with these guys. And the cool part is it's passed down genetically. So if many years of raising them, they get tamer and tamer and tamer and tamer and more accustomed to people and more willing to be held and all that. So you hatch a lot of tortoises, right?
Right.
So what kind of tortoises do you hatch? And so here's the funny part, how long do they take to lay, have to hatch?
That's about 3 months.
So 3 months, is that short? You have no long ones?
I have red foot long.
Now how long is a red foot?
6 or 7 months.
6 or 7 months in an egg. Can you imagine that? So they sit underground inside of an egg, under dirt, and somehow hatch. And then after they hatch, they have the same problem. Everything wants to eat them. Crows want to eat them. Birds of prey want to eat them. Raccoons eat them. So he's got to watch all this stuff. If you let any, pretty, you try to prevent everything from laying on the ground. Yeah, because if you don't collect them, so I collect the eggs in order to have a higher success rate. So I take the eggs from the mother, put them in a custom incubator. Now people freak out, oh my gosh, you're taking the eggs from the mother. In real life, if the mother knew that they're going to be a higher success rate, they would be perfectly fine with it. Because the mother, when the eggs hatch, they just all crawl their own way. Most snakes lay eggs under the ground and just leave, and that's done. So I figured some of you might want to actually touch a big snake. So when we're done, we're going to pull out a big snake. But right now, if you want, we're going to walk around. You want to go ahead and... Here, we'll slide that over. What was that?
Raffle tickets.
Oh, raffle tickets. So we're doing the raffle.
The raffle now.
We're doing the raffle. So we better get everybody around.